Okay, how you everybody doing? This is J.W. Sims, and I hope you all can hear me. This is going to be the first part of my tutorial on digital coloring. excuse me. On my Instagram, I ran a little poll to see which line art everybody wanted, and this is the one that won. It is the Jim Lee line art from X-Men number 12 cover, and I just want, before we start, I'm going to go in and just show you how I set up my line art to be ready to be colored, and some other things with my tool settings and stuff. I'm not sure that I'll show you me flattening the whole picture because it's just a long, boring process, but hopefully you'll get the idea. And then you can have any questions, you can put them in the comments, and I'll be happy to answer them, or to show you, like, if there's, you know, if there's something that I can help show you with, I guess. Alright, well, before I start rambling, we'll get started. First of all, when I get line art, this one seemed pretty good, but because I've already adjusted it. But like when I first scanned it in, it was kind of grayish, like the blacks weren't true black and stuff. So if that happens, you come up here to image, go to adjustments, levels, and then you have here, like, let me move it all off the line art. So you see, like, this first one, if you drag it, it'll make your blacks blacker. And this one, if you drag it, fades everything out. So yeah, usually I'll drag this one in, that one in, and then this one kind of just, you know, that's what it does. Anyway, so that's that. Jeez, sorry. Alright, and then for the line art itself, here it's named backgrounds and it's locked. I'll double click on that and rename it Inks, all caps, and the mode I'm going to change to multiply. This is a process that I had learned from K. Michael Russell in his class, his online course. Man, excuse me, I need to get a drink. Okay, sorry about that. Anyway, so then once you have that set up as multiply, you want to go here and you want to open up a new layer, and you're going to drag that layer below your inks layer, and this is going to be your flats layer. Okay, now this is where you're going to put all your color on, and you'll see. Anyway, okay, so let's the first thing I like to do, now this is where I do some things a little different than other people. I'm going to select the whole image, and I usually try to pick a color that I think I'm going to make this background. I'm going to probably do in some kind of shade of blue because this was the X-Men blue team. That's just my process of thinking. So I'm going to just go over here and just pick a blue shade of blue. I'm going to take my paint bucket, and now when you set up these tools, every time I go to use one, I'll explain how it's set up. If you can see, the opacity is at 100, tolerance is at 0, and I have nothing checked. Anti-alias, contiguous, and all layers, none of those are checked. That way, it'll make sense later. But so I'm just going to fill that in blue. And now this is another thing that I do different. Most people will tell you to start in the back and work your way up. I don't like to do that. I usually like to take my biggest thing and color that and separate that first. That way, I guess, so it's not as hard, not as much area to pick later, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna get rid of that. Okay, now you're gonna take your lasso tool, which I have set to L. I'm not sure what you have. And again, you want it set to 0 feather, and anti-alias unchecked. And now this is where you want to probably zoom in as much as you can. I'm going to come in here and take my, I have a Wacom Intuos tablet that I have connected to my computer. It's a little old, a couple years old. It's a little beat up. I need new nibs and things, but it still works. So we're going to go ahead and we're just going to start by selecting, we're going to do Wolverine here first because he is everyone's favorite. So you just want to go around and try to, I mean you can fix this later, but try to stay as much in the lines as you can. Now you can do this freehand, or you can also hold down the Alt key, and that'll let you kind of drag the line. I like to use that on things like this where it's really straight, because I don't have the steadiest of hand. So, and then you can just let go of that, and you should be able to go right back to drawing. Maybe. Come on. There we go. My computer's a little slow this morning, so. But, so you're going to do that for the whole picture. I'm going to select every bit of him. Like I said, it doesn't matter. I mean, you try to stay in the line as much as you can. We can always go back and adjust that later. Like you can, if you hold down the Alt button, you see you can go back and make sure. Oh, I'm sorry if I just like knocked you out there. And then when you add selections, you probably know, but you hold down the Shift button and see how it changes to a lasso with a plus sign. And that means you're going to add to what you already selected. As I said, this is the longest and most boring part of coloring digitally, is the flats. That's why a lot of professional artists, me included, when I'm doing actually something I get paid for, will hire a flatter, because it takes forever and it's not fun, but it's a necessary evil to make it actually look well. I mean, it's, and I'm gonna probably show you another thing that I do that most don't. Come on. Wow, it's really dragging, lagging. Okay, so I'm going to move back up top. I like to work my way down. I guess I think it's just easier on my hands, I guess. And I like to make my image as big as I can so I can have as much line weight as possible when doing this. Man. But, yeah, I think I'm just going to maybe do Logan and one other person, just so we can see how I select this all. and then it'll probably be somebody that's like right up against him, so Jubilee or Gambit. Let's see. Like I said, it's boring, it's long, and I'm not the fastest at it, so there's some people who are really good at it. I'm not that steady of a hand to be great at it. Okay, so you see when I was selecting this, man, I'm sorry. Just something in my throat today. But you see, I went a little out of the lines here, so we have to deselect that stuff. So that is the Alt button. And as you see, that turns into a minus sign. And we're just going to go right along him here. And we can take all of this out. And there we go. Alright. Oh, let me get rid of this other stuff here. Why won't it get rid of it? Well, I guess it doesn't really matter. It's outside the image anyway. So, anyway. Let's shrink this down, make sure I got it all. Okay. Now what I usually do, this is where me and other flatters, most of them you can just pick a random color and throw in here, but since I'm flatting for myself, just to save myself a little bit of time, I'll at least get a color that's close to what I want to use. So I'm going to pick like this gold color. I'm going to take my paint bucket tool, and I'm just going to color the whole thing that's one color. And now it's separated it. Control D. Okay, now I unselect. Now, what that does, it separates this, separates Logan from the rest of this image. So when I'm selecting, because of the way I have my lasso tool set up, when I'm selecting this, like I can, here we'll go up, I'm just going to show you here with the top of his towel. Like I don't need to be as precise. I can make a big glob around that part. And since as long as I make it a different color, it's going to be blue, but we're going to make it a little bit lighter of a blue. I can come back with my paint bucket tool and click on there, and it's how it just colored the parts that were yellow and did not go into the blue. And that's what you're going to do, is you're going to go through here. I'm going to separate all these blue pieces so I can dump in that blue paint. So let's see what else on him is blue. Alright, we're not going to, let me deselect that because I don't want to pull that around with me. We're not going to touch that because that's the glow from his claw. The glow, the glare. Alright, now I might make this a little bit closer just so I can really get in here. And because this, you want to make sure you stay in the line when you're on like yellow on yellow, because when you go to paint, it's going to put that color on anything that's, you know, if I click on the yellow to dump the paint bucket on, anything that's yellow inside of these selections is going to become that color. So I'm going to, and this is like where it really gets slow and painstakingly slow, because just selecting all the small pieces. Here. Now some people will go in and select all of, like, totally all the pieces, but I don't do that, like, because it's going to be covered with the black ink, so there's really no need for me to go in, you know, select everything. So I'm just selecting the parts of yellow that I want to color blue. Like I said, if there's any questions you have, you can leave them in the comments, and I will make sure to answer them the best I can. If I can't answer them, I will send you to someone who can answer them. I highly recommend, if you're interested in learning to color digitally, when I first wanted to, I went to some of my artist friends and who I know who used Photoshop to color, and none of them would help me. I don't know if it's like an artist thing, like you don't want to give away your secrets. I for one think all of us artists need to stick together. I think it should be more of a community and help each other out. If there's something, you know, an artist friend of mine, I know a couple of you have come to me several times to ask about different ways to digital color and, you know, or to do this or do that, and I'm happy to help you because, you know, it's the way it should be. We shouldn't see each other as competition. We should be a community to help each other out, and that's one of the reasons why I'm doing these tutorials. Just to show you how I do it, because some people really like to understand how to do it. So this is, again, I'm just going in here and selecting the parts that would be blue, which actually, this has always been my wonderation with, especially the way comic books were colored in the 90s. All these parts that are blue on Logan, were they really blue or were they black? Because the way that comic books used to be colored, I made a mistake, I want to get rid of this. I'm sure you know, Control Alt Z, and that takes you a step back and get rid of that. So let's zoom in a little bit more so I can get a better feel for this line. Wait, here we go. See, like I said, I have a very unsteady hand. If you know me, what's been going on with me, with my cancer treatments and such, my hand's not as steady as it used to be, which I think is one reason why I've gone more into digital coloring in the last 2 years, year and a half or so, and haven't done pencils as much. I mean, I still do it, but I've gone more digital just because it's easier for me to control, if that makes sense. But I'm sort of glad everyone picked this, because if you know me, Wolverine is special to me. I'm not going to go into that whole story right now, but I'm sure we all have different characters that mean something to us, and Logan and the X-Men have always meant something to me, so it's kind of fitting that this would be the first image that we use for this tutorial. Again, sorry about that. I don't know what it is. Where am I at? Okay. I was trying to see if what I needed to select. Okay. Like I said, again, this takes forever. And that's why I think I'm going to pause the video and finish selecting all of his blue, and I will come back when the day is new. Little Fred Rogers there. But I will come back whenever I'm done here. You're not going to miss anything, just me. Wow, what the heck happened there? Alright, it's just going to be me. I'm just going to be selecting the rest of this. You don't really need to see all of this. If I think of something that I need to tell you, I'll hop back on in the meantime. So I'm just going to finish selecting all this blue, which, just wait, let me see, I might almost be done with it. Yeah, it's just the rest of his hand. So I'm just going to stay here for this, because it's only this little section left. So, but yeah, a lot of people ask what flatting is, and it's kind of hard to explain. That's why I think I chose this to go first. Back in the old days, when they first started doing digital colors, I remember, like, in the image books, really, is where I first started noticing it. They used to call them color separators, because that's really what you're doing. You're separating the colors so that the colorist, which makes no sense because they're really not coloring, the flatter's coloring, but anyway, the colorist comes in and does the finishes, who, like, puts down the final colors and all the rendering, the color renders, makes it all pretty, and yeah, flatter pretty much. The way I flat, it ends up just looking like an old school comic book, you know, with just your flat colors, with no whatever, you know, because I try to pick at least close to the final color that I'm going to use in that area to try to save myself a little bit more time, instead of having to change it again. But once we get done with the flats in my next session, when I start to actually get into color selection and things like that, let me think. You'll see why we do this. Okay, it looks like I have all the blue selected, so we're just going to take our paint bucket tool, click here, and bam, there's the blue. Oh, I see I made a mistake here. See how I cut in here too far? So there's two ways you can do this. You can, and I see some other places too I gotta fix. You can just Control Shift Z, go back, and then, like, you can go here, take the colors back out, and then take your, make sure I'm on the right, okay, and then just my deselect lasso and deselect that. So then when I go here to my bucket tool there, but as you go around, you can really see it when you put, like, a dark color with a bright color. You can see all these little yellow specks. So this, I'll take my, go over here and select my pencil tool, and with that color, I'll just go through and fill this in. Just because you don't want any of that color to show through. And some people ask, why don't you just do this? Why don't you just take the pencil tool and color it in like you're coloring a picture? Well, that's kind of, whenever you're doing offset set printing, especially if, like, you're coloring for comic books, because these are on different layers. Wow, why is my computer so laggy today? It's on separate layers, so there's a chance that your line art, the inks layer, could slightly shift, and if you're only coloring, let's say, like, here, let's say I'm just going to color this with my pencil, with my pencil tool, okay, and then when they're doing the offset printing, if somehow the inks layer happens to just shift just a little bit, I mean, of course it's going to mess up everything, but just a little bit, which I can't quite do it just a little bit. Here. Oh. Well, this ain't a good example, because, but anyways, whenever you select that, when you do the lasso tool, it actually puts the color under the inks, so that way, you know, it can move a little bit and you're not gonna lose too much. And I can see some other stuff here while I'm here that needs fixed. Get off the inks layer. It's another thing, if you try to color on the inks layer, you'll see it's a different color. Fill that in and go here, select the background blue and just touch that up a little bit, I'm very I guess nitpicky with this stuff. Like, I will go through and try to get all of that color out. I guess that's just my way I am. Okay. So you can see we got all the blue done. Now I'm here, I'm going to do the eyes. And this is another important thing that I learned from K. Michael Russell, is when you're doing eyes and teeth, or anything white, really, you don't want to use white. Oh, man. I'm sorry. Because white, when it prints, it's going to, like, really white out. And so it's going to also, like, kind of wash out your colors around it. But he taught us a neat trick where gray has a tendency to trick your mind to think things are white or a certain color. They kind of absorbs the colors around them, takes on the property. So, you know, here this is, you know, pretty gray color. Anyways, that might be a little too gray. I try to get somewhere in here, there. And of course it looks a little darker gray because of the blue that's around it. But there's other times where you'll put that on and you swear it's white. And I can show you that in some other pictures. Let me see, here's one, something I'm doing for a friend. And I just did the flats on this. I haven't finished it. But here with the eyes, I mean, you come back and, you know, they look white. But if you select it, you can actually see it's not. You know, it's actually a gray. It's not a pure white like, say, this is. See? There's lots of ways you can use grays. Like I said, it's because it takes, like, the properties of the colors around it. Anyway, let's get back here, and I think we're going to do the flesh tone next. And again, I'm just going to go around and select his skin. And now, like I said, it doesn't matter that I go over here into the blue, because of the way I have my tool set up. When I go to fill this in, if I click on the yellow, it's only going to fill in the yellow colors that I've selected. So, you know, you can go, you know, once you get out here, you know, you can go like this, except when we get to the nose, because it's, okay, here we go again. Yeah, my computer is, like, really laggy, so I gotta come back. And see, I can get rid of, I need to take some of this line out of the yellow. Oop, wrong way. I mean, add, not subtract. Add, because I'm coloring the yellow. There we go. And I do believe, oh, down here in his arm, there's a little corner of skin, which I accidentally colored blue. So, what are we going to do here? I will show you what I'm going to do after I do this. So let's do the, oh, what did I do? Come on. Okay. Let me pick a skin tone. Let me see. I have lots of different skin tones here. Let me see if that's what I want. That'll work. D. And again, you see that's looks like skin tone, but it's really like an orangish color. I'm thinking about it. I use this extension for my colors. It's called Magic Picker. It's a it's just an extension you can get, Magic Picker. I have to put the link in the comments. I can't quite remember. It's from it's a store, I can't remember where it is, But I think I pay like $10 for this software, this extension. I like it. Compared to the regular color picker that comes with Photoshop. They also have a free trial you can download, which does this one still have? I didn't even notice. Yeah, see, I have the color picker trial still on here too, which that's what I started with, and then I purchased it. But okay, let me show you what I'm going to do with this skin. Just like up there, I'm going to select it, but since this is blue and blue, I can't really just circle it. I need to actually just go in and select it. That way, that's the only thing of blue that gets colored. So let me back this out a little bit. And now you can see Logan is almost colored. I just got to do his claws, and he'll be already separated, and he will look pretty much like he would in the comic books of that of the 90s, because there wasn't a whole lot of color separation. There was a little bit of what am I want to say? There was a little bit of like light on it. So, you know, to just show depth, and it's really changed in the last few years, I guess. It's really with the technology and stuff, the way you can color things now is just crazy. When I first started my first comic book back in 2015, I had taught myself how to color by watching YouTube videos, and I'll probably show you, compare it to what I was doing back then to what I'm doing now. Another thing that has really helped is Hi-Fi Colors, who does a lot of work with DC Comics coloring. They had put out a series of books that really teach you all the different styles of coloring. And if you can get those, I highly recommend them. They come with software that it's not really software, it's the Hi-Fi helpers. They have tools there. Like, I use some of theirs, but I usually use K. Michael Russell's only because that's where I learned most of my technique from, and those are the tools he was using during the course. So I just went ahead and like kind of just adopted those as the tools I used. Oh, I'm sorry, I keep hitting that microphone. Tools I use as well, because that's what I learned on. So just like when you're driving a car, if you learn to drive a automatic, chances are you're not going to go and start driving a standard just because, well, you know, and maybe that's not a good analogy, but it's my analogy and I'm sticking to it. So yeah, because it's really not good, because I learned on a standard. Yeah, see? And I prefer a standard, my glass. But I'll use an automatic if I have to. Anyway, I'm rambling. But you'll notice I do quite often, because I need to fill time while I am doing this. Now you're probably wondering, like, why do I care how this person colors? If there's any other parts of, like, I'm going to probably do some ways that I do set up pages for, you know, penciling, anything else you want to see, like, anything that has to do with comics, let me know, and I will try to make some other videos, or, you know, get some interviews with people, to help out, to help you out, and however you want to do this. Okay, so now I think I have all the gray, the claw selected, whatever. So I'm going to take a gray color, maybe a light gray. And there's Logan, all select, all color separated, and his loveliness. So, let me think. Who do I want to do? Because Jubilee's not really up against him. I have no idea what that is. I'm going to go do Gambit because he's like right against him. Maybe I'll do Gambit and Psylocke. And, or at least just do Gambit so you can see again. With hair. Hair is always a pain because it just goes everywhere. So really you just going to go through here. And this is where I'm really going to have to come back and fix it because it's going to just be willy-nilly. For the most part, especially against Rogue, because her hair goes every which way. So we're just gonna come down and just you can see, yeah, I'm really gonna have to come back and fix a lot of this because of the way her hair goes. Oh, I see it. I missed some of his coat back there. So, we're going to go back and get that. See, and here's his coat. And this is why I usually don't do the stuff in the back first. I usually like to start from the front and work my way to the back. That way you don't have to worry about going around all of this craziness. You can just zip right through it. But I decided to do Gambit next, so I guess I gotta live with it. Okay. Like I said, he doesn't have as much to do because he's in the background. And now one thing you do want to remember when you're going to do color separating like this, try not to repeat colors, like flesh tones especially, because when I go to color this and I select like the skin tone, it's going to select everything on this picture that's that color. So it doesn't really help if these two are the same shade, because when I go to color, it's going to want to color both of them. And the light, the way the light's hitting Logan is not going to be exactly the same way it's hitting, you know, Remy. So, let me get a brown. I don't know. I guess any brown will do because I can change it later. But okay, so there's Remy's all selected, and he is quite a different character because he has this red eyes. So I always like to do the eyes before I do the skin. I like to okay, so there's that one. That one. I might need to fix that a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna select this shade of red. And now we're going to pick his skin, but we got to make sure we don't go into his hair. So we just can't. Okay. And now, like, here we can just. Oh, I see I got her hair in there a little bit. I'll have to fix that. And I'll show you how I do that. Try not to select parts of his cowl. I'm doing this. any parts of his skin we see. And so we're going to use a different shade for Remy. I don't know if I like that color, but it'll work for now. But like I said, we messed up and got Rogue's hair in there. So what I'm going to do is select that background color, and I'm going to take my pen tool and I'm going to make it a little bit smaller so I can come on. I don't know why this is lagging so much. You know what? I'm just going to, maybe, if it ever stops, I'm just going to do paint bucket because it's faster. That. And I think I'm going to make sure this is part of her hair too. Okay, and we're going to glue that in. Okay, now, oh, look what I did. I forgot to leave his eyebrows brown, so I'm just going to take this. I'm going to try to pen it in as best as I can, but it's not going to want me to. So, again, MG. And I see his eyes. I messed up here a little bit too. So, Control D, and we're going to select that red. There we go. Alright, so his hairs are, ooh, look at that, I see lots of stuff in here I gotta fix. You see that, all of this? Ugh. Like I said, I'm really picky, and I see all this, like, hair is the worst. Literally the worst. I know this is a really long and boring video, I'm sorry, but that's color picking, and, or color separating, or flatting, whichever term you use, that's what it is. So, coat color is cow. Okay. Let's do his coat, and it's a lighter brown. Ooh, I see another thing I need to fix. Oh my god, I'm gonna go crazy. This is how I am with this stuff. Well, I try to make sure I get everything colored the right color before I move to the next. Oh, I'm coloring black. What in the heck? I was wondering why that looked weird. Okay. And here, let's get the little thing, guys. Okay. So now we're going to select. Make sure we don't select his cowl. Direction. Okay, thing's really lagging. What in the world? Okay. And now, this is a little trick I do, because I want it just to be a lighter color. I don't really want to go into, you know, trying to find the perfect color, so I color select it. Now I'm just going to come over here to my magic picker, and I'm going to just slide this up and make it a little bit lighter, and make it a little bit more orange, just so I can find a good tan color. Bam, there we go. Alright, so you see, it kind of separates that, and now we're going to do the highlights on his cowl, and I'm going to use that same old trick of things that are black, we don't leave black, if that makes sense. So we're going to select all of his cowl, that way we get all of this stuff that's brown. Over here I have some. Ooh, don't want to get into his eyebrow there. Already got two shades of blue on here already. The background and the blue on his thing. And we want this to be blue. I mean, there's lots of shades of blue, but I want it to be a dark shade of blue, kind of like this, but I don't want to make sure I don't use it, so I'm just going to change it a little bit just to so it's different and color that in. And then, since there's no more of that brown around, I can just loop around, select that, and that's like a pinkish purple, as I remember. I'm just going to put it this purple here, and then if I have to, that might even be perfect. Okay, so that's in a nutshell, that's flatting. Like I said, I'll finish this picture, separate everyone else out, and in our next video, I will start showing you how to add color to it, to color finishes, you know, to do, like, how to decide, like, how, where the lighting's coming from, how to add shadowing. Also, like, there's not much really on this picture. Maybe this, I might take that out and do my own glow on it, like a more modern type, but we'll see. That's easy. I just fill that in black and then go over it. But so this is step one of flatting. I hope you enjoyed it, and like I said, if you have any questions, or if you know, comment on some of the things, the way you do some things, I'd be happy to hear it. Just put it in the comments below. If you want to follow us, I personally am at @hooligan_cosplay on Instagram. Hooligan Alley Comics is on Instagram as well, and that would be @hooliganalley_comics. We also have, we're on Facebook, obviously. That would be The Hooligan Alley Comics. We also have a website, hooliganalleycomics.com. And of course, there's also a link if you want to follow any of our comic books coming out. We have Omni, should be being launched in July, with the writer L.C. Holt, who yesterday, pre-orders have come out on his newest movie, for the DVD release of Spiritus. LC is an actor, director, writer. He's best known for his role in the movie You're Next, where he played the Lamb Mask Killer. And he's also been in VHS 2 and a bunch of other stuff. But yeah, if you look him up, just in Facebook, put LC Holt, @LC Holt, L C H O L T. You'll find his Facebook page and the links to his to the Spiritus page where you can pre-order the DVD. Like I said, he's also the writer on our comic Omni that I hope you'll be watching for. And there'll be a link also in the comic in the comments where you can sign up for to get updates on that, as well as other comics we have coming out, like the Volume 1 of Fall from Grace, written by Daniel Hamm and art by Roy H. Stewart, which if you follow us at all, I've been sharing some of the Roy's been doing. So, but again, this was part one of digital coloring, flatting. So we'll go ahead and finish this up because it's going to take a long time. You see how long it took just to do Logan and Remy. So, just watch out for part number two, and hopefully I'll be able to get some live streaming done soon, doing some penciling and some other work that you might be interested in. So just watch for that. And man, so I know it's been a long, slow process, but that's flatting, like, as I said. So just stick around, go out and read some comics, and be a hooligan. Thanks.